I don't know how to put this, but I'm kind of a big deal.
Good evening, this is Dr. Bones Live. I do apologize for a little bit of a late start here. Just had a few technical snags, but they're fixed with now. And we're going to get going here with a new one that we were supposed to hear last week, but we got it all straightened out now because the link worked properly. This is one that's going to be on an album coming out by Allmark called as ATD Singles. The song is called Wow and Flutter. Check this out. Dig it. All right, that was Allmark, Wow and Flutter. That's on his upcoming album, ATD Singles. And Nessie, were you able to hear that song all right?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, because James at Allmark just texted me and said, where's the sound? And I'm just wondering, because that's showing clear here. So I'm just wondering if it came through all right. So Wow and Flutter, is off a soon to be released ATD. It's the name of the album coming out. And he's supposed to get them to me last week, but there was some problem with the link, but no problems. So we got it now. And Almeric is just a great guy in general. I interviewed him last week. And Wow and Flutter, excuse me, Wow and Flutter is just one of his many singles that turned out very well. And I just really appreciate it just because the mix and stuff like that. And just a quick note here, Peter Klein says I can hear it, so I'm not sure, Allmark, if it's your computer or not, but we're showing all good signs here, so we'll so hopefully you'll hear the next one, and the problem will be rectified and fixed. Just because I'm not sure, because right now, like I said, I'm showing all signs are good. Oh, something's wrong in his end, so I just got a message from him. So, all right, so yeah. So like I've said before about his songs before is Allmark is just very intuitive as far as the way he creates a sound and master stuff. And actually we do have artists that we'll be playing later on in the show that he actually does a master's for, and I've heard it for the first time today, probably a few hours ago, and I'm really excited to hear it. So let me finish up with that, and Nessie will get your thoughts on Wow and Flutter.
It's definitely a nice title, a title, and I really enjoyed that. It kind of smoothly flowed the whole song, and that there was not that much progression, but it was very melodic in sound. And I like that there was kind of a mystic feel about the song because it was just smooth and having that upside and down. So it was just nice listening to it because there were steps and down, but it was just kind of smooth and gentle flowing.
Well, and that's it. And there's a lot of mixes of like house music and dubstep and everything calling all combined together can give you a really decent sound. It's just a matter of kind of opening your mind to the may not excuse me. I'm trying to think of the words I want to put out here. It may not necessarily be the perception of it, but just the way it kind of comes out and flows. And it's just one of those ones we've been learning more and more about recently because we've had Peter Klein and Allmark. We'll call it not necessarily techno, but it just the electronic sound in general, and how abstract and how avant-garde it is, and how it's that kind of music where some music like that it's very repetitive, but there's changes up, and they kind of give you the more insight of how hard it is and how much work's put into it. Because the only other person we've had close to this is Squid Thief, and an at-term offensive, offensive. Wow, I've been having problems with my words all day. Even in Blogger's Corner, I've been kind of stumbling over my words a little bit. So, at-term offensive, who is the Squid Thief, as well as Luke Casale mixed in. So, it's very respectable music. You just got to kind of open your mind and take it in and kind of just listen to it bit by bit because it's more in depth than one might think.
In respect to Almog and Peter Kleine, just wanted to add that their music in general is very thought out one, and you can definitely tell by listening that they try to convey certain feelings and tell a story just by the sound of the song without adding vocals or lyrics. They just make it sound right, and you can definitely tell there's some narrative aspect within the song still, even though there are no lyrics.
Well, and that's it. And that's what was interesting and exciting about these interviews is the fact that it was like I said before, doing these interviews just in general, even though it's been about 2 years, excuse me, excuse me, a bit of a cough here. Anyways, point being, excuse me. Okay, I think I'm good now. Anyways, point being, what I was, oh my God. Okay, what I was alluding to is the fact that it's a learning process for me each interview. And the fact that we're introducing new types of music into the fray makes it that much more interesting because I know a little bit about it, but I'm learning a lot more because of these gentlemen, and it's made it so much more interesting for me and I'm more appreciative now of the music that's being made as opposed to just kind of dismissing some of it as the same old kind of drum loops and beats and that sort of thing over and over again. Got it? Okay.
Just
I
looking
thought
for
you were gonna chime in there, so I just kind of give you a little bit of a pause there.
was well put. Pretty much summed it up all suit.
All right, well, right on. So next up, we're actually going to get into a brand new one from Peter Klein, who just sent me this today, speaking of who. And the song is called Shambhala, and I hope I pronounced it right, because it's it's one of those names. Looks good, but also kind of funny to say too, and hopefully you pronounce it right. So yeah, Shambhala, and here we go with Peter Klein. That was Peter Klein with Shambhala, and always good to hear new stuff from him. And we've pretty much heard quite a few of his songs already. We've heard about four songs, most like I think, in the past few weeks. And I like talking to him because it gives you much more appreciation for music, where because he doesn't really use any programs. It's just kind of straight out kind of synth, whatever he's using at the time, and you really only get one shot at it, so he can't go back and do like an overlay or switch it up because he made a mistake. It's kind of one shot deal only, which makes it that much more interesting. Just because it's hard work. It's not as easy as everybody thinks. It's one of those things like you really gotta have a good ear for that, and you can't always get it on the first try anyways. Just because it's just one of those things that as we've found out over the past few years, or even just being big fans of music, knowing that songwriting, whether it has lyrics, no lyrics, or it's all instrumental, what have you, it's a hard process. It's not It's easy. Someone thinks to kind of sit down and say, okay, you know what? I'm going to write a song. If it were that simple, there'd be tons more bands. Everybody would have a band, and obviously that's not the case. So all the respect to the people who do work hard and put their thoughts into it. And obviously there are those who are pretty much, we'll call it, let's say, manufactured by the quote-unquote big record labels, saying, you know what? We're going to put you four together and you're going to do this type of music and it's gonna sell. And 9 times out of 10, they're right just because they can find these people to write these songs for these bands who more or less have a look. So more or less people are buying into the look and a bit of a catchy loop. And, you know, it kind of takes the fun away from music in general. It just seems like that a lot of thought, not a lot of thought and not a lot of hard work was put into it.
Yeah, it's definitely nice to see bands and musicians in general, they, well, try to have some certain appeal to the listener by their image, but in fact by their sound, and that they put thought behind it, and that they try to convey certain feelings and tell a story. And what I really liked about the song was that it was kind of dreamy, but had tonal depth, and that there was some constant, well, I'm not sure if it was some drum bass line because it's definitely electronic music, but it was nice that there was some eclectic instrumental layers, and that it was smooth in progression, still dreamy, but had some vibrant tendencies too.
You know, and one thing I want to mention too is it's in relation to this and Allmark's song is just the drum beats in it, the little drum beats here and there in it. On the other day, on Tuesday, when I was talking to Allmark for the interview, before we came back on the air, and a couple times when we were on the air, he joked around saying, you know, I do beatboxing too, which was really cool. And one of the kind of that we'll call the beats he beat it out reminded me, and I just we talked about so many different things, I didn't have a chance to throw this in, but I want to point out to him right now, since I know he's listening, is there's a song from the Nine Inch Nails album called The Slip, and the song's called Echoplex. And the beat you were spitting out a few times before it got back in the air was pretty much the exact beat they have at the very opening of the song. I just want to mention that because when I saw that song live, it was one of the coolest things I've seen in my life because the way it was set up was perfect. What they did was they put up a screen pretty much from left to right, so they filled the entire stage. And what it was if you can picture the Wheel of Fortune board, you know how they have all the squares and they're all dark, and once they hit a letter, it lights up. You know what I'm talking about?
I'm not sure.
Okay, let me try to put this to you this way. Okay, picture a wall of bricks, but they're all white. You got that?
Yeah.
Okay, so now picture in some areas, some of the bricks are missing, so all you see is red. Now, does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
Okay, so now that we got that, so what happened was Trent Reznor, he was out on stage in front of the screen, and the beat was going along, and it seemed wrong to him, so he's standing there, he's looking. And what he would do is we'd touch certain squares and they'd either remove and turn to red or fill in and turn to white. So it kind of fill the beat in where it was supposed to go.
Okay.
Okay. All right. So he did that until the beat was right. And then once that was done, then the screen came up and then the actual drum beat came in. The drummer was right there drumming away and they started the song. So it was really cool and very well done. I was very impressed with that.
Okay. Definitely sounds impressive. I don't know if all musicians would have, could handle the situation and get everything done that needed to be done to start the song, so.
Well, like I said, I just brought that up because, like, when he was beatboxing, it reminded me of that drum beat, so I just wanted to bring that up because I didn't get a chance to mention it the other night, and it was just something I kind of came to mind. So, on that note, we're going to get into our next music, and this artist in particular, I'm following on Twitter, and it was informed about her from Allmark. The artist is called Jazzy Cat, so we're going to listen to a song of hers called Finding the Truth.
But Kevin may be in some danger.
In danger from what?
As strange as it might sound, someone may be targeting people like Kevin.
They mean people like Kevin.
People exhibiting wounds that might be interpreted as having religious significance.
Alright guys, sorry, just a quick second here. I wanted to play another song first and then that one, so I do apologize. I know you guys were kind of probably getting into it, but we're going to start with Actual Physical Contact and then we'll get back to the other one. So let's start with this one. I apologize for the little mistake here, but let's get going with this. This is Actual Physical Contact. This is Jazzy Cat.
Beckman? Beckman!
Disgusting blob. I'm going to have to hold him myself.
Physical contact! Can you move?
All right, on. That was Jazzy Cat with Actual Physical Contact. What were your thoughts on this one, Nessie?
It was definitely a laid-back track, but still had vivacious moments. I really like that like the other songs, it's rather smooth in sound and have no ups and downs, but it was very melodic too. It's just, as I mentioned when we talked a few seconds ago, it's nice to have music you don't have to concentrate too much on, but you can just enjoy because it's just flowing nicely, and you know that there's thought behind it, but it's not too, well, just forcing someone to listen. It's just there, and you enjoy that it's there.
Well, exactly, you know, and I have to admit, there's a couple parts during the song that kind of reminded me of, do you remember the band Dirty Vegas?
It definitely rings a bell.
The song was called Days Go By.
Okay.
And it was kind of like a techno-ish sounding song, you know, and it had lyrics to it. And there's a couple parts in this song we just heard, Actual Physical Contact, that reminds me of it. And it's the one that's Days Go By and still I think of you. It's like doom doom doo 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 doo. Days go by and still I think of you. Don't sound familiar at all?
No. Actually,
no. But
thanks for trying.
Yeah. You know what? To everybody who's listening, you're lucky because this is twice today you've heard me make an attempt to sing. So thanks for still listening after that. Because well, because earlier today, if you listen to Blogger's Corner, I was talking about Bruce Springsteen did a cover of Lorde's song Royals, and I said, well, you know, if you can picture Bruce Springsteen in your head, because just of the general way he sings, and it's like I said, it's kind of like he tells you what he did that day, and he's the blue collar, like middle class, hard working American, and blah blah blah. But just the way he pushes his voice sometimes, you know, and like I said, you know, could you imagine him saying, you know, you could be my beauty queen, and I just that was the first thing I thought when I read that article, and I just started dying laughing. It's like, this is way too funny. I mean, respect to both artists, but wow, I just never would have pictured him covering at least covering her songs, but covering that song in particular.
Well, actually, I haven't listened to that yet, but I listened to you talking about it on Brit's Corner, so definitely have to check that out. Sure is interesting to listen to.
Yeah. Like I have, like I said, I haven't heard it either, but I'm very curious to just to hear how it turned out. But you know what? Sometimes some of those kind of songs and the people who've done covers of them, sometimes they turn out better than you actually think. You know, you kind of put it like, give them like a kind of, say, like a low grade and just kind of go into a thing, you know, this is going to suck. And now it may surprise you. And the reason why I'm bringing that up is this is about probably almost 10 years ago. I had some buddies come up to my place when I was living in Michigan because they wanted to see Kiss in quote-unquote Detroit Rock City. So they came up to see the show, and you know, obviously we all went together. And when they came up, they were just one of those things where, you know, they were so excited to see Kiss, and they had like CDs of like Kiss, like rarities, that sort of thing. And have you ever heard of a movie called Adventures in Babysitting?
No.
Okay, well, that's not important because one of the songs that's part of the movie, and it's on the soundtrack, is called And Then He Kissed Me, and it's like a female band from the 50s, 60s. I'm not sure who the band is. Anyways, Kiss did a cover of that song. And you know what? It actually wasn't that bad. as cheesy as it was, it actually wasn't that bad. They actually did a pretty good job of it.
Sometimes people just surprise you because you can't imagine quite well if they can put something new into the song or just do the song justice or just play the song like it is and just add nothing new to it. you see that they make their own version of it, but still keep, well, the general structure of the song together. So definitely can be nice and take you by surprise.
Oh, and that's exactly what I'm saying, is you never know. And there are times, obviously, and sometimes more than I like, but where the songs are just brutalized and you just want to say, like, what were you thinking?
Yeah, it's definitely kind of an issue if it's from a different genre. They try, well, to put it into their genre. Well, imagine if there's someone taking, like, a ballad or something folk music and they try to make a rock song out of it. It just don't seem right. It just don't match with the song, the initial arrangement.
That's pretty much the best way to put it. So we're going to step off that and we're going to get to the second song here by Jet's Cat, which we started listening to and heard about a minute of, but now we're hearing the full thing because I corrected the mistake and I do apologize for that. So let's get into Jazzy Cat, and the song is called Finding the Truth.
But Kevin may be in some danger.
In danger from what?
As strange as it might sound, someone may be targeting people like Kevin.
They mean people like Kevin.
People exhibiting wounds that might be interpreted as having religious significance.
Thank you. Right on. That was Jazzy Cat with Finding the Truth, and this one was a little different, but still cool, because obviously the beginning, for those of you who were X-Files fans, that was from the X-Files, and you could tell a little bit, especially in the end, a little bit of a tunage from the theme song for X-Files, so that was really cool, and it was kind of, you know, bit of a nostalgic sound for me at least, so it was really cool for me. I really enjoyed it.
Yeah, I definitely have to agree on the point of nostalgic, because I really like that it was very melodic in sound and definitely had some haunting aspects too, because as the other songs, it's quite smoothly progressed in sound. It has some elusive feel about it too, something mystic about it, and it's just interesting to see where the song goes and how it develops.
Well, absolutely, couldn't agree more. So next up, we get time for one more here, and then we'll have to shut down Startup for a second part. But we're going to finish up the show here with a song called Postcode, and the song is called Losing the Battle. Dig it.
You.
Postcode with Losing the Battle. A very cool kind of rockin', almost kind of somewhat mellow just in the way the tune flowed melodically, and the vocals kind of dropped up and kind of to the little monotone, then up a bit higher, then come back down again. And it just the way it stood out was, to me, it was that way. It was like one of those, it kind of flowed, we'll say, like evenly. And they did good. I swear to God, I probably need a lot of sleep here. They did a good job with it. But anyways, the way it flowed was very nice. And I really appreciated the way it was done, just because, like, it was kind of like a perfect up and down, as opposed to, like, you know, they're up too high for too long and then they drop way down, so it kind of doesn't flow properly.
Yeah, it was definitely nice to see that they combine rather rousing elements to the rock side of the song and rather mellow, gentle elements too. And I really like that the vocals were quite stable, but stirring still, and that the whole atmosphere of the song was kind of energetic, but still laid back, that they tried to play with contrast, and really like the wavering riffage of the song. And it just progressed smoothly, as you said, had its ups and downs, so it definitely kept the listener attentive to the songs, but still it was very well put together.
Very well said. All right, so that will conclude the first part of New Music Saturday. We'll be back in a few minutes here, so stay tuned. We'll be gonna be turned down here just for a minute, and we'll be back in about 10 minutes. Until then, Bones out.